Please leave your message after the tone.
Hello, this is William, and you don't know me, but your cousin Michael works for me at Claustra Studios, and he has not shown up to work at all this week, and nobody in the office has heard from him. So, of course, I stopped by his house to see if he was okay, and his car was in the driveway, and I swear I thought I saw someone walk by the attic window, but nobody answered the door. But I did find a note on the door, which is why I'm calling you. And it just has your name, number, and a message that says, finish the game. So, you know, Michael's known around the office for being a little bit off, but this is strange, like, really strange even for him. And, you know, as I'm sure you know, he typically keeps very to himself, but he has talked a little about you and how you guys used to write the Choose Your Own Adventure stories together. So, you know, I hope you know what this all means, and of course, I hope Michael is okay, but we really need to get in touch with him. So, when you get in touch with him, please tell him to call us at the office. Okay, thanks so much. Bye-bye.
Dr. Miller, it is January 23rd, 1983. Could you state your name and age?
Hey, why is this being recorded?
This is just for record keeping and review purposes. I promise that these tapes aren't going to leave this office.
Okay.
So, name and age?
Michael Krieger, 32.
And what brings you to see me today, Michael?
I thought I filled all that out on the paperwork.
Yes, but I always like to ask. It's just nice to hear you share it in your own words in person.
Well, I guess I just feel kind of stuck.
Could you expand on that at all?
Well, a lot of it is work. And don't get me wrong, I'm grateful that I'm able to work for a video game company. It's what I love to do.
No, it's okay. Say it how you feel it. You don't have to censor yourself.
I thought I'd be able to express myself a bit more, you know? I'm really craving that creative freedom. And I get there's a market for those fantasy games we make, but I just feel like I could be making more.
What do you mean by more?
Something real, something that would make you feel something, I don't know.
And is this feeling just related to work?
No, but it's a big cause of it.
So, I did want to talk to you about what you wrote in your paperwork. There are certain things that I find concerning. I'd really like if we could talk about that, if you're able.
Yeah, could we not? At least not yet. I'm just not...
No, it's okay. I understand. We can circle back to that later, okay?
Okay.
Thank you. recording. Okay, this is Dr. Miller. It's currently February 12th, 1983, and I'm talking with Michael Krieger, age 33.
32.
Right, sorry, age 32. How are you feeling today, Michael?
I mean, I've been worse.
Been up to anything exciting?
No, not really. I've been watching a lot of movies, but that's about it.
Oh, what movies?
Mostly horror movies.
Oh, I can't watch those. I'm a bit too jumpy. Why horror movies?
I guess the feeling I'm trying to get, it's like I'm so numb. Maybe if I find the right movie, it'll make me feel something, but it's like none of them are enough.
I can see how that could be frustrating.
Yeah.
Have you, been writing in a journal, like I suggested?
Oh, yeah. I actually think I'm taking to it a bit more than I expected.
Well, that's great to hear. Is there a reason you've had a change of heart about it? I know you weren't super thrilled last time we talked.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I found a use for it.
Well, that's really great to hear. So, I did want to ask about where we left off last. I know you don't like to talk about it, but are you having any more thoughts of hurting others, hurting yourself?
I know what I wrote on the papers. It sounds bad, but it's more fantasy than anything. It's not like I'm planning on doing anything. They're just stories.
I understand that, but if they continue coming to mind, then...
I promise, I'm okay.
Okay. We are recording. This is Dr. Miller. It is March 20th, 1983. And I'm speaking with Michael Krieger, age 32. How are you doing today, Michael?
Actually, I'm doing pretty good.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I think I've got something figured out.
What do you mean by that?
Like, you remember last session how I talked about feeling stuck? I think I found a way out.
Oh, and how's that?
I decided to make my own game. Something that no one at the company would understand. It's gonna be amazing.
And what does everyone at work think about this?
I haven't gone in a few days.
And why is that?
I feel stifled there. Yeah, I go back, but I need this time to work on my work. I need to focus on this one thing.
Well, I'm glad you found something, but... please remember, you need to take care of yourself, too.
I know. Trust me, this is all gonna be great.
Well, it's great that you found something.
Yeah, don't I know it.
And are you still writing in that journal?
Oh, yeah.
Would I be allowed to see it?
Not just yet. It's not quite finished yet.
Finished?
Yeah, it's not done.
I'm not sure what you mean. The journal isn't exactly something you finish. It's more like a continuous stream of thought.
I know. Just... I'll let you look soon, okay?
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you.
Dr. Miller, I'm speaking with Michael Krieger, age 32. It is April 16th, 1983. How have you been doing, Michael? Michael, I asked, how are you?
Don't act like you care.
Excuse me?
I know you don't.
I'm sorry, I'm not sure where this is coming from. You're working on seems unhealthy. I understand you're passionate about this horror game, but some of the things you're writing seem sadistic. And I think it would be best if
we... Don't you dare! Tell me what's best for me, you fucking bitch!
I think we should take a step back and...
No! I'm done with this! I found what makes me feel better, and I'm gonna stick with it. I'm about to create a masterpiece in gaming. Hell, I'm creating a masterpiece of any art form. Why would you want to take that away from me?
I'm sorry, Michael, but I don't think this is good for
me. Don't pretend like you know what's good for me. You know I've spent my whole life just wanting to create. I just want so bad to let the world know what's going on inside my brain, and I finally found the message I want to send. I'm gonna be the horror auteur of the fucking millennium. Do you know what it's like to be told your entire life that your ideas are shit? It's too dark. It's disturbed. It's not. It's art. And I'm ready to show the world what my art can be.
Thank you. Krieger, age 32. And today, we're speaking with, drumroll please, Dr. Miller. How are you feeling today, Doctor? Oh, Dr. Miller seems to be a bit shy at the moment, but I'm sure she'll warm up once she gets settled at the house. Her husband, on the other hand, is being a bit more difficult. The game is almost ready to go. I just need a few more participants to act as props, and then everything will be set up perfectly. I know we haven't talked for some years now, but knowing my playtester, he'll be here as soon as word gets out that I'm gone. Someone should come looking for me soon enough. I should probably put that note out. And hey, if you're listening to this, I really want to thank you for everything. I know you're probably a bit freaked out right now, but I wouldn't be doing my job if you weren't. I just know that of anyone, you'd understand the importance of what I'm doing. Now, I know you weren't a fan of my ideas when we were kids, but I can only assume you've matured since then, right? Ah, what am I saying? I know you'll understand. Okay, I need to get this finished up. You are in 4-8 Street. Goodbye.
Thank you.